Hey everybody, it's Jang here in my main Lego room, where the last time I showed you a major feature, it was over there to the right, the collectible minifigs wall. Well today, in this video, rather than turning to the right, I'm going to turn you towards the left. I've not shown you my parts collection since 2014 in a completely different house. You've seen what's in the middle here. This is my table where I do custom builds now, so I'm currently working on the train station, as of the time of the recording of this video, but I'm going to take you through these bins. Now these bins have all of my Lego parts. There will be some that you won't see in this video, but I want to take you through most of it. I'm going to have to go through it very quickly because there's so much, but I do want to give you a good overview and also explain why I've separated out some things the way that I do. These are Sterlite bins, so there's the name of the company there. You can find these at, or have been able to in the past, find these at Target, Walmart, Amazon. They're actually very, very common and in multiple countries. Normally they come with a limited number of drawers, so you'll get a unit that's like that size there in the center with just three large drawers, or there will be two large drawers and then two small drawers, but they're modular. So you can take them apart and put them together in different ways, kind of like Lego in that sense. So you can kind of customize things up. And there are a number of different companies that make things like this. It's just one of the more common ones to find, at least in the US. So I've gotten a lot of these over time and just put them together in ways that make the most sense to me. Speaking of making the most sense to me, throughout this parts tour, you will see stuff that will not make sense to you, or that you will think could be done better or should be done better. And that's great. That is one of the key essences of successful organization systems, that different systems of organization will work for different people. So the way that I've done it is, first of all, flexible. So things change over time, but it works for me. And that's the most important thing. As you know, I can find my parts. So none of this is wrong per se, even though some of it may not work for you, and that's perfectly fine. I'm going to start you with color, stuff that's mostly sorted by color, and there are different ways, depending upon how many parts that I have, different ways that I've separated some of these out. So this is all dark red, but this is a combination of regular bricks, also rounded stuff, slopes, and plates of different shapes are in here. No modified stuff. This is starting to get fairly full again. It was really full, and then I did some Minecraft Nether stuff, and then I got some more parts. So these, you know, kind of ebb and flow with how much stuff is in a given bin or within a given set of them. Next, red is split into three. So let me show you what I've done here. This has red bricks, just regular rectangular bricks, plus large panel pieces that I tend to use like bricks. Here are round pieces and slopes together into one area, but separated from the rest of the bricks. And then here are plates of all most shapes and sizes put together. Comparing that to orange, where again, everything is put together. This is actually going even farther in the direction of putting more things together, because this is two different colors. Technically, it's three different colors, because this is old bright light yellow and this is new bright light yellow, but it's mixed in with orangish yellow parts, just because I don't have that many parts in those colors. Yellows are split into three, just like red. Here is lime green, which is all together. Green, which is split into three. Dark green has a combination, so I've also put bright green in with there, because they're very contrasting. You know, it's obvious you can pick them out easily. And then down here, I've actually got two different bins. One of them combines two different colors together, sand green and this bright spring green color together. And then olive, all the olive stuff. This will probably have to end up becoming its own full drawer eventually, because it's getting pretty full with just that half drawer there. This is a combination of a bunch of different colors, all the medium and light blue types of colors. So medium blue itself, this lighter powder blue, you know, sand blue, medium as your dark as your, got Maersk stuff in a bag that's actually buried under there. So all those end up being combined together. Blue itself, the normal blue, is split into three. Here's dark blue. And then we get into brown, which is also combined with dark brown. Brown is actually split up into four in this case, where I've taken bricks, again, just because of the sheer volume, bricks, slopes, curves, and then plates. It all comes down to, you know, how much I have of each thing. Here, some earthy tones put together. This is dark tan all together, and then regular tan is split into three. And there are some more bins down beneath the table. I'm not gonna get into those. Those get even more mixed up. There's a lot more light here, so let me turn down the brightness a bit. This is where you'll see parts that are split out the most. Amongst the things that are done by color, these are split out more than any others. And this is a repeating pattern here for light gray, or new light gray, light bluish gray, dark bluish gray, white, and black. They're all separated out in the same ways. Bricks and large panels are all together. These are all slopes. These are all curves. These are one by plates plus these. It's just an association that my brain makes. Makes sense, easy to find. Two by rectangular plates plus two by two round plates, regular ones together. And then all other, well, almost all other sizes and shapes of plates together. So that just repeats down there for dark bluish gray. White, again, same thing, done the exact same way. And then black is the last set of them down here. And that's mostly it for the stuff that's primarily sorted by color. Moving over to this next column, this comes into transparent stuff, and this is miscellaneous, small transparent stuff for the most part. There are a number of colors that belong here that have not been separated out as yet. At one point I had just one single drawer, and just over time as I get more stuff, it gets split out even more. So I've already split out red here, red small transparent items, blues, which include dark blues, light blues, and transmedium blues. And then these are transparent bricks, so larger things of all different colors mixed together. And this has gotten much larger, much more quickly than expected. Moving on, I guess a little bit more color-related stuff here with silvers. And silver, well, there are two main silver colors, a bright one and a medium one, but these tend to kind of get moved back and forth between different places, and some of them you'll actually see duplicated some other places where I'm starting to change things out, but it's kind of in flux. Silver and gold, right? This is a funny one. At one point, for a very brief amount of time, there were a lot of parts in a drawer like this. It's all my sand red. I've used up all my sand red, except for just these pieces here, as far as just regular parts are concerned. All the rest went into my nether, my Minecraft nether realm display. This is classic gray stuff. Most of my old gray system-related stuff, including the darks and the lights and all different types, including things that are not by any means bricks, you know, some more specialized stuff. So this is kind of a place where I go when I need spare parts to complete classic stuff, or if I want to do something classic themed, or for some reason I just want to grab one of those old colors. Here are the pinks and magentas and lavenders and purples bricks of all types, including round and slope. And then same colors, plates of different sizes. And that pretty much does it. There's some miscellaneous stuff down there. It's not really important to go through. And then larger plates. Oh, I mentioned that plates previously weren't all plates of a given color. These are larger rectangular plates in white, light bluish gray, dark bluish gray, black. I'm gonna skip one. Brown, or reddish, I think it's all reddish brown and dark brown, and other colors. Way too many of those, way too many of those. Need to use more, been using more, but need to use more still, because look how many I have. The one that I skipped kind of needs to be moved down, just haven't gotten to it yet. Should be moved down here probably. Modified tiles. This actually doesn't belong here. This is Originally, this was large modified tiles and large tiles, but some of this is kind of in flux right now. I think these technically should go way down below to the one that I didn't get to yet, which is this. See, more of these large 8 by 16 tiles. This also has my 16 by 16 plates in here, octagonal plates, ramps, open octagonal plates, one of these. Yeah, that's pretty much it for what's in there. Large plate-like things is kind of what that comes down to. Now, get to move you over to the Technic stuff. This was my original miscellaneous Technic stuff bin. And it has changed over time, but has never been emptied. It's never been emptied and fully sorted out. I've taken some things out over time, but this is a real classic for me because it takes me back to the beginning of my part sorting days as an adult when I started doing lots and lots of Bionicle stuff. Back in, what was that, 2009-ish or something like that? More Technic connectors and such, larger ones. These were originally more specialized ones when I started to get stuff that I didn't want to include in here, but this has grown quite significantly over the years. Needs to be reduced down, to be honest with you. I have more there than I'll ever need to use. Technic stuff continues with the thin lift arms, including the cam or lobe shaped ones. These are basically two types of inline connectors for the most part in there. More connectors. This needs to be reduced down quite a bit. I've got far too many of the blacks and the light grays in there, and I'm starting to bring in some other newer part designs like these, which were previously separated out, and got also these guys here, which were previously on their own. I have so many now that they kind of belong in a larger bin, and also these, which are relatively new. So this needs to get, maybe we've got some old gray stuff in here. There's just way too much black and gray though, more than I'll ever need. And then these are all roughly in the same family, includes straight ones and angled ones. And the Technic stuff just continues. Axles, including axles with stoppers of all lengths. These are joints, large joints, mostly, well, half and half, Technic only, and stuff with bricks attached as well. Technic plates, more Technic miscellany, mostly stuff that has studs on it. Also some links just in a bag, just because they needed someplace to live. Technic bricks 1x1 through 1x4, and Technic bricks 1x6 and larger, including rectangular ones. That does it for that column. All right, we're moving pretty quickly here, but there's still so much to go through. All kinds of gear-related stuff. Lobed gears, Borok eyes, including my precious glow-in-the-dark pair. Miscellaneous powered stuff and power-related stuff, including, you know, battery boxes and lights and cables and things, light covers, fiber optic cables, more. This is getting more into the large action figure related stuff now. So I've had some of these for quite a long time. This is miscellaneous round Technic-y stuff. How do you even describe it? I mean, there's a bunch of different types of things here, but as long as I can find the parts, it's all good. It's working. Large action figure. Also, small version of large action figure weapons, including Borok shields here. This has been reduced dramatically over the years. These are projectile weapons, and these are projectiles. Right, and those new ones as well. Projectiles and projectile weapons of all sorts. These are like wings and blades. Larger ones, also some of this small stuff. These used to be in a completely different. All these were separated out in different ways in some smaller bins, and have kind of brought stuff down to a more standardized size, which just feels more comfortable to me, and there's more room to kind of do like this. It's very important to be able to do that to find stuff. Also, because these bins are clear, you can look from underneath them. So So you can find stuff that's down on the bottom. That's good. I don't know if that's focusing or not, but you get the general idea, right? Where did we leave off? Oh yeah, here. Armor and armor add-on pieces. These just kind of went together, but yeah, miscellany. Large action figure, more, talk about miscellany. This is my microphone cord is all over the place right now, but one of my many miscellaneous bins, which just has all kinds of different stuff in it. A melting pot. And then talk about miscellaneous. This is one of the most miscellany bins that I have. Pullback motors, transmitters, 4.5 volt train stuff. I think this is a Quattro or Primo. Dude, this is a part that I used for painting things. There's also a part that I used for painting things. I want to have a limited number of those. This is Duplo. Dice. Miscellaneous. Miscellany. And we move on. All right. Check it out. We're over here now. There's still so much to do. Gotta speed up. Come on. Okay. This is flat decorated stuff. Small-ish flat decorated stuff. Things that are printed. Not all things that are printed, but a bunch of them. And things with stickers, obviously. Lots of things with stickers. Larger versions of the same. Larger, flat-ish, printed and stickered things. These are screens and consoles and computer-like related things. Back here I've got eyes and numbers and letters and license plates. Things that primarily have numbers. These have started splitting out from some other bins, but this is mostly decorated bricks and such that I feel were especially useful for city related things. This is an old bin here of all of my larger decorated, well, most of my larger decorated stuff together. And then panels, decorated panels. Also a bag of the Scooby-Doo stickered pieces because there are so many. Stickers, speaking of, plenty of those. So absolutely crucial for small scale mock making. Stickers and decorated parts. It's one of the little known secrets. You know, a lot of folks tend to think that mock making is all about skill. Well, skill is very helpful, but you also need the parts. And when it comes down to small scale, if you add one single sticker to something, it can make all the difference between it being completely boring and looking completely right. These are cloth and paper parts for the most part. More large action figure stuff that's kind of just left over. There used to be several whole columns of large action figure stuff. We've really reduced that down this past year. Heads and masks, feet and hands, old leg and arm pieces. That'll be reduced some more. CCBS armor pieces and CCBS bones and torsos. Mixed together, different colors. Here's another miscellany bin, but this is miscellaneous special stuff. So things that are extra special to me, extra odd. Some of them are very old. Some of them might be rare. Some of them might not be. Strange things that just haven't found houses anywhere else. You consider these to belong with Zymor spheres, but you know, they're from the German football team. Haven't put them there yet. I think I'm just gonna keep them here for now. Interesting stuff. Lots of interesting stuff. Some you may not even recognize. Some you may actually recognize. Just all sorts of weird stuff. That's rare, especially to get in such good shape. This was split out from that miscellany probably a couple years ago. Already, I've split it out even more. Special round stuff, including those black Baraki eyes, and then here are colored minifig heads with no prints, some with prints that are not faces, and some more specialized round stuff. These are all just specialized pieces, things that I consider to be more special pieces, more special than normal. And these get to be sorted out into smaller little areas. Very conveniently. A lot of open spaces, very important for organization to have space to expand. Like these are the same thing, just needed more room. But yeah, space to expand is so crucial. So crucial. Robot related stuff, bars, more bars, bigger bars, various types of bar related things, hoses and tubes, some ladder elements and some elements that BrickLink considers to be bar or bar related, chains, tree toppers, ExoForce arms recently just put into that bag. Some of these things used to be separated out into multiple things, like for instance these were separated by shape, every single different shape that you see here had its own place, and recently I reduced my numbers of those and just put all these together because it's I don't use them that frequently and it's easy enough to find stuff there. Strings and string related things, propeller like things, construction site related stuff. This makes me happy just to look at, but I need to do more of this type of stuff. And train related things down here, including bogies and axles and buffers and wheels and whole motors and such. Bunch of train related stuff there. Moving on, I think things will get a little bit easier from here. Some special, more special plate shapes that I decided to put together. These modified plates, let's see what they are. Several different types of parts were included here, but they make sense to me to go together, so I'm always able to find the stuff easily. These are just by themselves with plenty of open space there. That's good. These just recently got promoted to drawer status. Previously they were all in a bag, but I have enough space to put them into a drawer. Cheese slopes. Panels. These are smaller panel pieces. Getting a little bit wider with panel pieces, and these are panels that are two studs wide but not large enough to go with bricks as yet. Tiles, smallest tiles, larger tiles that are still one wide and two wide, two stud wide tiles. Jumpers, sorry I just hit the table behind me, but jumpers, including these, I consider these to be jumpers. They might as well be. I mean, they're modified tiles with studs on top, so they go there. Oh, also these go there because my mind associates them with these. They came out around the same time. Again, whatever works, you know, in the eyes of the beholder. Textured bricks, more textured bricks, and we move on. Grills and things that are kind of related to them in their general design. Some of these are using multiple little slots. Because why not? These all go together. Forget the proper term, name for those, but look at that, more open space. Now we get into hinges, ratcheted hinges, female style, male style, brick style, rounded style to work with axles. Some of these things are decorated, but more close association with the use and the type than with decorated or not. More hinges, including some older style ones. Oh yeah, here we go. I was hoping to have easy access to one of these really old ones. Cool stuff, I've got some older than that in there also. Ball joints, the smaller Mixel style compatible ball joint stuff tends to go here. Older hinges, pantographs over there. These are articulating plates. Hey, lots of open space here. Plus turntables, including modern and older styles of them, two and four stud. These are modified plates, one by, these should all be one by one modified plates with clips or a little bar holding hole thing off to the side. Then we switch to things that have clips on them that are larger than one by one plates. So there are one by one bricks here. These are technically considered to be tiles, modified tiles, I think, but they have clips, they belong here. Larger plates, and then this is kind of the same thing again, but with bars on the side, which includes the vertical bars and the horizontal bars together. Just made sense to me. It's quite a lot of stuff in here. Studs on the side, bricks of various types. Small studs on the side brackets, you know, 90 degree stuff, including these, belong here for me. Larger brackets, several different types in here, and larger brackets still, including some older styles down in here. All right, this next one is one that I like very much once we get part way down. First, we gotta get through this, which is a little bit of a mess. Roundy stuff. cones and engines and domes. Do those really go together? For now they do. I'm able to find the stuff. This makes more sense. All these things together with mostly quarter cylinders and half cylinders. Discs at one point separated out into, or started to include, I should say, these. They were close to disc-like, and then once I included these, I had to include these because, you know, they didn't want to be left out. It's always the way it is. It's politics, man. Politics of Lego part sorting. Parts have feelings. Come on. Roofs, all sorts of vehicle roofs. More vehicle-related stuff here. Things that I consider to be vehicle-related. So small doors, like the old style of car doors, engines, steering wheels, wings, and also seats ended up going here. Preformed seats, a couple different types there. More vehicle-related stuff, kind of continues with that theme. Exhaust pieces, antennae, taps, not really so much vehicle-related, but they kind of just ended up being happy here, so I'm happy for them. Handlebars and horns. Talk about vehicle-related stuff. Look at all this. It's all various types of bonnets and fenders all together. Quite a collection. Various different scales from different subsystems. Then we get into my wheel and tire collection. This is kind of the miscellany of that, but it's good miscellany. Some of these things are separated out in bags. Some of them are not. This does include what BrickLink considers riding cycles, so three-wheeled ATVs go in here, motorcycles, bicycles is also where I've started to put the new wheelchair and these types of wheels and various other types of wheels. Kind of special wheels are included in here. Oh, look at these. Talk about special wheels. Yeah, this is good stuff. I enjoy this. Vehicle bases. That's where I got a junior's base from recently. Axles to use for wheels, including all these Technic ones. I have too many of those, but I might end up using those as a texture element in my Planetary Defense Force base. This is the drawer that I use the most for vehicle mocks. These are just the sizes of wheels and tires that I like to use the most. These are some less common colors of those. And the 6mm ones that I use absolutely the most. There's a bunch of those now, that's good. Larger wheels and tires from Speed Champion size, including their wheel covers, going up. Also, these older, more vintage types. Larger wheels and tires still. And I have a very large bin of even larger ones than this, but you're not going to see those now because they're in a completely different place and I almost never use them. Finally, treads down here. Treads and pieces to use with treads. Different types, plastic ones, different sizes, and also rubber ones of different ages. Cool. Here's another column that I like. Hey, we're getting towards the end. This is good. Another column that I like. These have recently been resorted quite a bit. So I've got some empty space here to kind of expand some things out some more as needed. Windows and windscreens. So these are mostly four wide ones that are used on city vehicles, although these probably don't belong here. I just dumped all these together recently. Getting a little larger. Yeah, these go here. Six wide mostly. And then larger and more miscellaneous things start to fall apart, you know, over time a little bit, because it's like, what all do I put together? Some of it's based on how much I have, how much space it takes up. This isn't a windscreen at all. Well, I guess it is. It kind of counts. And then these are, you know, cockpits and cabin types of large, mostly preformed pieces all put together. And then we get into regular windows that are used for buildings and such. So these are most of my smaller ones. They get larger. I have far fewer of these than I thought at one point. These are strange windows, from these classic one by one to like bay windows, skylight style, you know, just strange ones in different sizes, awkward size. I don't think they even make any window panes for those. And then doors and window-like doors and door-like windows, stuff in that size and shape. These are panel pieces that can be used as windows, and they're in various different sizes and colors. Some of them are even decorated. Finally, down here, this is mostly glass inserts for windows, some old, some new. Door stuff these days should be going up, but nah, this is fine. Oh, these, stuff changes over time. These round ones just happen to fit here also, and then these are mostly decorated window and door panels, except for this bag of these red ones that I got really cheap off BrickLink one time. These are the 4x6 inserts. A bunch of them in there. I'll design a building just to use those. And now, okay, we've got just two more that I'm going to show you in this video. So I've actually made pretty good time. There's so much to look at. This was originally designated as a place to put castle-like and medieval-like stuff. And this contains a lot of different things, from cannon to these, like wizards, castle, spires, a lot of medieval related stuff. Fence and fence-like things here. This is kind of mixed up, so some ladder-like things, some slides. Where would these even go? They just didn't have a home of their own. So they got mixed in here because they're kind of big things, kind of airy, kind of works for me. Yeah, this is another miscellany bin. I'm not going to spend too much time here because these are large bags of things that just don't have space to go anywhere else yet. Garage door pieces. These are all tails, like aircraft tails. These lamp posts just recently got split out. Octagonal bricks, rotor blades. I don't even know what you call these. These eventually I'll find some use for. Just a bunch of random big stuff. And you'll see more random big stuff pretty soon also. These are mostly like large fuselage pieces, is what I would consider these to be. This would go with large miscellaneous stuff, except it doesn't fit, so it goes here. It's just kind of renting the space temporarily. Supports, mostly vertical supports. This is good stuff. Lots of it will definitely be used more over time. Larger supports still, including those large girder pieces. Maybe I'll be able to, I don't know if I'm ever going to be able to fit a bridge into the current design of the city. And yeah, this is the real mess of large miscellaneous stuff. Some of this stuff, I mean, what? Why? Really? These are cool. Nice. Okay. Yeah. Medieval castle related? I don't know. Bunch of stuff in here. It's a real mess. Has to happen. You can't have a proper place for everything. Lego just makes way too many parts. And then finally, this is the last thing that we're going to go through in this video. Oh wait, there's one more thing after this. So foliage. So small foliage items here, including flowers and flower stems. Larger kind of preformed foliage things went here, including all of my trees, but all of my preformed trees are currently in use, which is a good thing. More like medium-sized foliage items. That's a nice looking thing. It's just nice to look at. This was my large rocks bin, which would contain lerps and burps, but most of my lerps and burps are not here because they're in use, which is also a good thing. So it's left some of the more eclectic stuff behind. containers, container-like things of various types, including trash cans and cabinets. Various chests are in there. Some of my tracks, I have a very large bin of extra tracks, both plastic and 9-volt, but these are just some to have easy, quick access to them, of various types, including some of the rarer stuff. Trailer bases and train bases. Animals. Animals. This big bag is dinosaurs, but there may be some down below as well. But animals and animal-related things. And then this last one really gets us into stuff that I'm not going to cover in this video because it would take way too long. So I'm going to cover it in a separate video, which is all this here. It's all my minifig construction kit, which has dramatically increased in size since the last time I showed it to you. So this is just a super quick preview of that. Like I said, it's going to take a while to really go through this, and I want to be able to explain some of it and, you know, go through a little bit more casually. But this video is way too long. I did say that I was going to show you one more thing though before closing this one out, and that's this section over here that I kind of skipped past. And it has base plates, so road base plates, regular base plates. Some of these in here are going to be printed, I think. This is a printed one. Some clear ones, you know, some special stuff, some not so special stuff. And then the larger 32 by 32s. Some of these are printed, some of them are not. Like all those are not. This is just regular brown and white. And then these are some different sizes of ones. These are official Lego sizes, but then also some cut ones. Because, you know, when I get out to edges of things, not everything fits perfectly, so I do allow myself to cut base plates to fit out towards edges. I mean, Lego has cut base plates officially in the past, so I allow myself to do it. And there we go. That's it for this video. My goodness, that was really long. But I did go through it pretty quickly, I'd say. It's a lot of parts, man. It's a lot of parts. And even at that, still, just the process of building things, especially in a small enough scale to really go with minifigures within limited space, still requires that I make new purchases and get more BrickLink hauls in order to be able to complete things all the time. That's just one of those things about Lego that folks don't like to talk about. To do custom stuff, yep, you gotta have the skill, but you also gotta have the parts. Lots and lots and lots and lots of parts if you want to make things the way that you want them to be. Otherwise, it just doesn't really end up working as well as you might expect. So there we go. That's my parts collection for now. First time you've seen it in full since 2014, and I still need to go through the minifig related stuff. Hope that you've enjoyed this. I've got more stuff to show you in this room as well. Thank you for watching up to this point, and of course, thank you for your support. I will be talking to you again very soon.